Well, we finally get famed Houston rapper Cornbread on the show, or so I think, and it turns out we're not getting Cornbread. We're getting Maurice E. Duhon Jr. Maurice, how you doing?
Good to hear from you, sir. I'm doing quite well.
Okay. I gotta ask you because there's a lot of folks that listen to the show that were excited we were having Cornbread on, but then I go to your website and there's some dude Maurice E. Duhon Jr. posing as you,
with a
statement that says, and I quote, "A return to prudent and accountable government." You're not gonna have any street cred left with comments like that. What are you doing? I mean, hold on, just to remind people, at least my favorite.
We looking at you, looking at Pokemon Pikachu, looking at, can you hurry up in there? I got two boo-boo, looking at, I wear a tutu, look at my new tattoo, look, didn't get the memo.
You cannot go from that to a return to prudent and accountable government. You can't do this. You're going to disappoint people.
I believe it's possible. And let me tell you, following a path to prudent and accountable government will get you all the street cred you ever wanted in your life, because that means you're contributing to the betterment of your fellow citizens.
What?
Yeah.
What has happened to you?
I tell you, that is it. Now, to the folks that were excited to maybe meet Cornbread, I hate to disappoint them, and I would tell them that I wish they would have partook in the activities we had when that was going on. But I had to place all of that to the side and represent for a very large group of people in the 18th District of Texas that are just not satisfied with the performance of their United States Congress and maybe even their United States Congresswoman that is currently taking the seat right now.
You do realize that FCC regulations prevent us from saying her name because she has a high position of authority, so we're not allowed to say Sheila Jackson Lee's name in the middle of an interview.
Well, you know.
You're getting in trouble, you know.
Let me
ask you, Maurice, because you said this. Are you going to Congress to represent your district? Or are you going to Congress to represent your district?
Well, what we have to understand is the gravity of the conversation we're having here. I'm a federally recognized independent candidate for the Texas congressional seat of the 18th district. When I filled out the needed paperwork to the Federal Election Commission, nowhere on it do you see any reference to a character or a manifestation named Cornbread.
With two D's, by the way.
Yeah,
because there's a lot of Cornbreads, but you're Cornbread.
Yeah, can you blame me, Mr. Barry? I'm from the South.
I'm not mad at you. You got me confused.
Well, you know, we all have hobbies, Mr. Barry. We all have hobbies. My hobby just happened to be something that caught on pseudo worldwide. Now, with the satisfaction.
No, I don't think it's pseudo worldwide. I've seen the number of hits. You got a video that says, "Can you believe we got 1.1 million hits?" And there's 3.3 million hits. So at some point after you said that, it went even more viral. No, you're confusing me. I'm not mad at you.
Well, you know what? If our Congress folks were doing their job, I would have stayed in that position. It would have been lucrative for myself. And it was fun to see so many people get pleasure out of my art. But rather than turn into a cynic politically, I had to say, you know, before you give up on your district and your economy and your people and escape to Europe to perform for those folks, maybe you should use your gifts of communication for the right reasons and go ahead and represent for the district. Give the people a chance, and if they don't follow you to a better day in Congress, then feel free to, you know, partake in your artistic endeavors. But
now, wait a second. Did you just very casually take a shot at the incumbent Congresswoman for taking trips to Europe?
No, not at all.
Okay, because I want to be very clear. I could not be for that.
I'm offended. I'm hurt. Not that I have anything against Germany.
What's Sheila Jackson Lee not doing? Why do you want to replace her?
Well, let's see. I would say she's not a congressperson who is willing to rescind or remove a percentage of her congressional salary to be utilized towards a reasonable, rational, or sustainable project that will promote beautification or commerce in the blighted areas of the 18th district. And if that's not possible, I would even ask if someone like herself or her constituency in Congress would pay down the national debt with some of that huge salary they get, and then look to their other friends and fellow distinguished gentlemen and gentle ladies to do the same thing I'd like to see some legislation introduced from the district that would bring forth a conversation supporting our need for congressional and senatorial term limits. That is something.
How many terms should there be?
Well, it's a conversation we can have, Mr. Berry, but let's at least have it. I'll say 20. Let's start at least 20. Goodness.
Well, she's got 2 years left on 20 because she went in 94.
Well, you know, let's just have the conversation every day in Congress, okay? And while we're doing that, let's also remedy the massive water main issues that's going on in this awesome city by introducing some legislation that would provide tax breaks for proprietors and contractors who are involved in infrastructure building in the city. You know, we're ignoring a huge water main problem down here. And to be honest, in Houston, we're ignoring a whole lot of things because we've just given up on the facilitatory process of our congressional seat. And I'm ready to see that change. I think I can be a new voice and a better choice for the district. And we've got 10 some months to talk about that.
Maurice, can you hold for a minute?
I can hold for 5.
Maurice, does it help your case to have instant name ID running for Congress against Sheila Jackson Lee as a rapper?
Well, you know, let's get it straight. I'm running for Congress as a realtor. I'm running for Congress as a citizen. In the day and age of futuristic sound bites and stuff, of course, it's great that, you know, we would get introduced to the conversation because of my past hobby. An art form, might I add. My job is to take this advantage of being introduced into the political conversation and use it to direct and mold the conversation to where it belongs. And that is, what is the legislation that's coming out of the 18th district? What are the legislative bills that are making it out of committee?
I agree. Let me ask you a couple of questions. I'm going to ask you for a quick response, all right?
Sure.
You are on the hot seat.
Got
Maurice
it.
Duhon, Jr., the 18th congressional district. I notice on your site it says medicinal marijuana.
Yes,
we
sir.
Need more or less medicinal marijuana.
You know, folks have got cancer. Folks have got diseases. One of our largest allies, Israel, is one of the largest producers of medical marijuana research. You know, there are things we need to think about with pain and
just death. Just yes or no, Maurice.
Oh, yes. Medical marijuana for people with disease and affliction, yes.
All right. I'm going to ask you for yes or no's on these.
Gotcha.
Yes or no, legalize marijuana for everyone.
Decriminalize it right now. Sorry.
Legalize it. Does that mean legalize it?
No, we can't legalize it right now, but we can talk about it, but we can decriminalize it and get a lot of African-American young men and women, a lot of Latino men and women, even a lot of Caucasian men and women.
What? You got white people smoking dope in my America?
There are Caucasian.
Are you sure? Now, don't go crazy, Maurice.
No, I have proof. There are Caucasian
people. You've seen white people?
In the streets, Mr. Berry.
I got to tell you, Maurice, if you're an independent candidate, you're going to have to win a couple of white folk. And white folk do not refer to themselves as Caucasian.
Well,
that's what black people say in mixed company. I'm just being honest with you.
Well, as an African-American, as a black man, you know.
Maurice, let's not get carried away. You are the lightest-skinned black man I've seen.
Look, my family's out of Louisiana.
Yeah, I know.
All shades and colors.
It's Duhon. I know exactly what it is. Don't be getting too proud. Welfare reform, yes or no?
Well, yes. Welfare reform. Educated conversation. Welfare is actually holding some folks down. Let's have a conversation.
What are you, Alan West?
I'm sorry, yes.
No, I mean, what are you, Alan West, with this holding people down? Next thing you're going to tell me is that all these payments for unwed mothers are actually busting up the black family.
All these payments for unwed mothers are busting up the black family. We've got to reverse payments to actually income. We've got to get people producing income and producing products. We've got to get people to work. And we've got to get the people that are working now into careers so the people who aren't working can get into jobs.
How does the government do that?
Woo! Well, we've got to lower the corporate tax rate, okay? We've got to make it competitive for business. We've got to make it an incentivized situation to maybe bring the work back to America.
Well,
we can give incentives to bring it back and put our good citizens back to work. Let me tell you something, and we're going to have to get real serious. When you look up Cesar Chavez, huge Hispanic leader for labor and Hispanic relations, Cesar Chavez was known for busting illegal immigration situations as a Hispanic civic leader. Okay, that was something, but he had to explain to his own people, his gente, as I would be so bold to say, that we have to do this because as Hispanic and Latino folks, those are our folks, but these are our jobs. What I can do is similar to what the honorable former Congresswoman Barbara Jordan was able to do, is to take as a person who is on a committee of Homeland Security or a bordering state. You have to be embedded in the border control, border security situation and conversation. And the only way to solve our issues with the border and labor are to, on one hand, create, as on the website it says, a comprehensive, realistic path to citizenship while also imposing certain situations for accountability when it comes to hiring non-documented workers. We have to put the people that are in this country right now back to work, and we can do it. But when it comes to Mexico, we have to have an educated conversation to work on three things: border relations, border security, and that pesky path to citizenship. Because we've got a sign on the Statue of Liberty that's really contrary to a lot of what sometimes we say down here. And that says, you know, bring us your tired, you're weary, you come on. So if we're not willing to change that sign, we better get to rationally thinking about the situation.
No, but if you read the whole thing, and it says at the bottom, but you do have to have papers or we're sending you back. It's very clear on that.
This is true.
Let me ask you, give me a grade, a letter grade. You can use pluses or minuses if you want to hedge, sure, on the job Barack Obama's doing.
Boy.
I mean, would you give him a D minus or an F?
He does a lot of jobs. He's passing. He's going to the next grade. But what I'm going to tell him is, the honorable president, is this. I'm going to say, I want to see you in honors class. I want to see you in AP class. I want that for you. I want that Vanguard education. Next semester, if the position is given to you, let's take it up a notch. And let's create the things that are going to put you in the history books. And,
but you do understand that as a black man, you are not supposed to publicly criticize the first black president. That violates the rules.
I'm allowed to rationally state what I feel. And he is allowed as a citizen to retort, and his supporters are allowed to retort. But I will say this. As an independent candidate for United States Congress in a district that is held by an 18-year incumbent seat, as a political rationalist, I have to step away from the presidential conversation of 2012.
Well, let me ask you this.
Only be reserved for the 18th district talk.
That district has come to count on Sheila Jackson Lee as a speaker at funerals of people she doesn't know. Will you commit to do that?
I will speak for anyone in the district who says our Congress presence is needed.
Okay, Sheila Jackson Lee gets to the State of the Union address at least 10 hours early to get a good seat and be on TV. Will you promise to do that?
You know, I want to, I understand, you know, the seat that I am honored to receive in that State of the Union address, I'd be more worried about the Houstonian that I invited that night.
Okay, well, she wears bright primary colors so she can be seen in the crowd, sort of Skittles style. Will you at least commit to do that?
Now, I am a fan of a nice suit, but my suits are very, very subtle. I will blend in. It's the voice that's going to break me out of the crowd. So, yeah, we can't depend on my clothing. I'm gonna blend right in with the clothing. I have some nice ties. I have an awesome necktie collection. But it's the voice that's going to take us to that next level.
We will talk again in the course of the campaign. Maurice E. Duhon, Jr., independent candidate for Congress from the 18th Congressional District. Thanks for being our guest, my man.
Thank you, sir.